There is so much to talk about after the first round of the World Cup. Our predictions were 100% correct, but it was the battle of the war dancers that got me excited. New Zealand and Samoa both tried hard to scare the living shit out of each other, with New Zealand getting the points in a sloppy affair. Fiji sang beautifully and continued that passion into the game with teamwork and fluidity. But for me, Tonga won the war dance competition with a convincing display of tongue flashing and arm bashing. And they won the game as well. I'm Brandon Gay, and to help me dissect the cup, the man whose face is doing his own war dance, the man who thinks roid rage is all in your pants, Gary Farmer.
G'day, Brosnan.
Any thoughts on round one, Gary?
Yeah, plenty. Look, the war dancers were exceptional, weren't they? And look, having a clear understanding of each of the Pacific cultures, as we do, really helps you to appreciate the challenges that have been thrown down.
a clear understanding. I'm not sure anybody that isn't a Pacific Islander has the slightest clue as to what the war cries are actually saying.
Oh, I do.
Really? How so? I know you spend a lot of time in Tonga, but you're not Polynesian.
No, well, I'm not from Polynesia. I'm not from Micronesia. But I do have amnesia in the blood. Anyway, I've translated the Tongan war cry for you. Well, I've loosely translated it anyway. Roll the tape, please, Andre. Okay, we can see here there's just a bit of a psych up as they move around and remind each other of their rich heritage and who's playing in each position, some moves, that sort of thing. Yep. Who here is Tongan? We are. You heard it here first, we are Tongan. But you should already know that as you're actually playing against us. Yeah, you're playing against us. I'm up for a game, anybody else? We are. Where's a breakdancing mat when you need one? We just turned your hot water off and put itching powder in your shorts. Don't think you can come into the bourbon and beefsteak without ID, particularly after the lockout curfew. If you try that again, we'll be forced to tell our greatest Tongan player of all time, John Hopewadi, and he will not be pleased. He will take you on and tackle you once, twice, three times, four, five, six, and I think you know what that means. And then you will surely know how painful it is to play against Tonga.
There is no way that that is what they are saying.
Disprove it.
In other games, Australia and England were predictably a bit scratchy, and they both have a bit of work to do. It was great to see the PNG Kummels feasting on the Welsh, wasn't it, Gary?
Well, it wasn't a feast so much as finger food, Brendan. Literally.
For me, the USA disappointed. I thought they may have made a better game of it against Fiji. Yeah. And the same can be said for Samoa.
Yes, both America and Samoa basically peaked at the anthems, didn't they? And now it's time for a new segment, On the Couch with Merlo. What have we got this week, Brandon?
It's actually a Pinot, Gary.
What the f***? It has to be Merlo. It says on the couch with Merlo because it rhymes with on the couch with Sterlo. That's the piss take.
Well, I don't like Merlo. I like Pinot.
Well, when we take the piss out of a segment named On the Couch with Dino, you can drink Pinot. Until then, Merlo, Sterlo. Get it? Look, just fake it like you have your tan. Andre, cut to an ad. I can't work with this.
Let's take a look at round two. Australia take on France in Canberra on Friday. Prediction, Gary?
Kangaroos by plenty.
I think the French will come back and put on a better showing than last round against Lebanon.
Well, what with? They got Taz Bateri's nephew and John Rebo's great-granddaughter. Australia by 60.
Then on Saturday, England versus Lebanon at the SFS.
That's a home game for Lebanon now with their super coach Brad Elfitleb. They may well cause a few problems for the Soap Dodgers, who are without Sam Burgess.
New Zealand versus Scotland in Christchurch and Tonga versus Samoa in Hamilton. How do you see those games?
I'd say New Zealand by 40 plus and then Tonga in a close one versus Samoa.
And on Sunday, Fiji versus Wales in Townsville and PNG take on Ireland in Port Moresby.
In the Battle of the Hymns, I'm going with Fiji. And I've got to say, now the Kumbles have got the taste of victory, perhaps they're going to add potatoes and Guinness to the menu.
And finally, Italy and the USA meet in Townsville, which could be a good game.
Could be a good game, but I think, you know, well, Italy are going to win by a slice of salami.
You may be right.
I am right. Join us next week for round three. He's Brandon Gay.
And he's Gary Farmer. See you next week. Does my tan really look that fake? I got it in Sorrento.
It's as fake as your wig, mate.